What's good? We're back here in Pillars of Eternity inside Cade Nua's throne room, I think the guy commented on or something. Or, no, we read in the description. Well, this kind of looks like it'll be a throne room. But, we healed up, and it is actually daytime out right now. You can't really tell. It looks like it's moonlit in here, but it is, in fact, daytime, as you can see down here. Actually found, as you can see right here in the bottom right, there was like a whole set of ghosts that I didn't loot for whatever reason. I guess I got totally distracted. But saw them on the way out, looted them, we're good now. So we're going stealth mode.
Not a sound.
Quick save. There is a ghost up here. In fact, there's a lot of ghosts up here. Okay, get up in on that, start attacking that, hobbling strike,
I'm here.
Wow, killed it, instantly, that's always good, huh? Let's get this phantom, swap weapon, better when you're not stunned anymore, try and do a knockdown. I don't know if that cues it up or what. Let's see. Do one of these. AoE attacks from Aloth. He's starting his chant. Let's see, I don't really want to use any priest spells yet. Maybe that's a foolish thing to say, but we'll
how
see.
May I help?
Okay. Aloth, more AoEs, please. Just do it right there, right on poor Edder's head. Swap the weapon. Keep on attacking that phantom. Wow, okay. Maybe we want to start thinking about doing free spells, huh? I like this. Do this. Whoa, man! Holy cow. Let's see. The hit chance on that is really low. Is that the hit chance? Let's see. Maybe we try this? No. This? No. I'm really not sure. We'll just try and shoot him, I guess.
Not.
Gosh, Edder. My god, my man. Okay. Another heal, please.
It's on me.
Oh gosh, the skeletons are ready. Send in the skeletons! Jesus! Someone save Edder! He's really not doing well.
Hey, love.
Oh, he's down! Oh, gosh. We need more magic.
Blast!
Oh, gosh, our friend is going down now, too.
Be on seek.
Come on, get your skeletons off. Nope, nothing, huh? Okay. Jesus, this is tough. All these phantoms or something. Maybe I shouldn't have been so conservative with the spell usage. Trying to target this one. There we
and
go.
Into the fight.
Lava.
Jesus Christ.
Beyond seek.
She went down too! Well, that's not good! Holy crap. Try and get that guy.
How may I help?
Man, this might just be bad. This might be real bad. Wow, holy crap. It started so well. Okay, we gotta reload. Okay. Take two. This time yes. We'll get him. This time, for sure. Okay, you fucking ghosts. I don't know how to... Okay, there we go. Unstealth. Head over for that dude. Go after that guy. Charge up a shot. Missed. Shit. Okay. And then... Do some AoE action. Interdict, if possible. Jeez, man. Heal. Please. Okay. How much healing does this do? Okay. Get up in there and consecrate the freaking ground, man. God, oh man, he's really getting hurt bad. Our melee is, like, stunned out the butt, too. Wow, he's down already. That is so not good. Look at this. We'll try again, try again. Okay.
Yes?
Move everybody up. But we won't reveal, what's his name? First. Along with the others. We'll send them...
How may I help?
And then he can go in. And then our ranged will start. Eloth, use your freaking thing.
Love.
Wait, what's it immune to? Was it his attack? Probably the hobbling. Okay. Which makes sense. Okay, we'll attack that one next. Okay, she is stunned. Edair, what are you up to? See if you can't knock that thing down. Actually, try and knock this one down. And then Durance, go up in there and consecrate early. Consecrate early, consecrate often. Right? And then Aloth, AoEs.
Combat.
Jeez, man. Okay, Aloth. Good god, man. I'll AoE as well. How much damage does this do? Only 12.4. I mean, shit. Who gives a shit? We need it.
Keep it together.
Oh, she almost survived. Okay. We're actually doing okay. She went down, but we're doing okay. What else have we got here? Let's try one of these at this shadow. No, we didn't kill it. Do another one. Same guy. Durance is getting messed up. Oh, he got messed up real bad. All Okay, holy crap.
Hey.
Aloth, Jesus, my god. Try and shoot that.
I'm here.
Nice! Oh my gosh! Okay. Holy crap, we might pull it out! Come on, Edder, hang on! Oh Jesus, I should've used that earlier. Oh! Oh, the skeletons! This will be what saves us.
Get off, bud.
Oh, this is the savior. This... No, he got stunned!
Curses.
Oh, fuck.
Watch out!
Oh, God.
Lava will be on seat.
Oh, God. This is it. This is it, baby. Can I not hurt... I can't hurt the guys on the ground, right? Oh my gosh. Oh no, we're both stunned. We're both stunned so bad. No! 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 Aloth, come on! The hero, Aloth! Oh, shit. Shit. Alright, let's try it again. Gosh. This is a tough encounter. But I feel like our engagement was right. We had a good way of engaging. And then you guys start firing. Do the lance. This is such a tough engagement, maybe we shouldn't fuck around. Like, we should just be going all in all the time.
Yes?
Okay. Durin's go in and consecrate. Holy crap, dog. What are you going up in there? Okay. That seems unsafe. Who are you fighting? This one, huh? Okay, Aloth. More single target, I think. And then...
Following your lead.
Let's see, fire this shot off. Okay, please. Jesus. Jesus, please. Actually shield him. Withdraw him. Emergency withdrawal! Oh! No, he went down! That's not good. That's not good at all. Okay, Edis. More stuns. We need more stuns. Let's see. Which one's low? That phantom? We need to target it down. Okay, you, my friend... need to... This. Huh? Burn damage. Some sort of cleansing fire. Okay. Knock that one down. Let's see. What else can we do? Can we do this? Mm. Is this going to have a good effect? Does it have no effect? Holy shit, that's not good if it doesn't. Okay, more attacks, more attacks. Okay, do one of these. Okay. Then kill that shadow if you can. Okay. Didn't work out that well. Ooh, that's almost perfect placement. Because that extension won't hit our friendlies. Better, please, use your heal! Please, my good man, use your heal! Oh, dear God.
Okay.
Mowing.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, my God.
Anna.
Oh, Edder! Jesus Christ, man! You're really in there!
Moe.
Oh my God! This is intense! It's crap! Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh! He can't get off his self-heal because he's just constantly being stunned. Please die, you bastard! Please die, you vile bastard! Please, you vile, vile, ghost asshole of a bastard! Please die, please do not kill my friend. Oh, please. Oh, please. Please, dear God. Oh, thank God! Oh, thank you, Barath, Aethys, and Magrin, and whoever the hell else. Oh my gosh. Holy shit!
Following your lead.
Okay, let's use a triage on this guy. On that air. Oh look, okay, it's a heal over time sort of thing. Okay, he's back up. We're lacking a lot of spells. But we'll investigate what else is in this place. Maybe there's just one enemy? What, like one pole? That'd be pretty nice.
Being quiet.
I mean, I feel like that's not gonna be true. The gray and brown pelts of mice flit between the boards. Wait, just the pelts? The brazier's chains are rigid with rust. So there's some stairs to the top floor. Maybe there's probably going to be some arch wizard of hell. Some sort of doorway. Oh, steward. As you come to the end of the great hall, you perceive an inviting warmth radiating from a grand throne wrought out of marble, its masterful artistry out of place amidst the castle's more practical stonework. The veiled face of a woman is carved above the throne's backing, watching over the room with hollow eyes. As you approach, you feel the warmth fluctuate, as though stirring. A voice rings out from the carving, permeating the fortress through the stone and air. Ooh, the throne is a lady! Ooh, that's weird. If you sit on the throne, there's like a lady statue breathing down your neck.
Another watcher in Cadmus.
Kinda kinky, though.
Glowing very brightly indeed to these eyes. What strange happenstance.
You know what I am?
One could hardly mistake it. You're burning like a candle. Of course, I also know what to look for. In any case, I assume you're here looking for Meowald.
So, the throne speaks. Is that what's happening here? Are you imprisoned in that throne?
Imprisoned?
What was that noise?
At times it feels that way, I suppose. But it's more that I reside here. The throne was brought up from the ruins. One of the first things they found. As a last favor to a dying woman, the Earl arranged for me to be moved into it. Audra is an accommodating vessel for a soul.
Wow, this is like Portal, huh? There's going to be like a series of traps and stuff, and she's going to test us. In Mantis Men.
Oh, it's not as confining as it seems. I can feel the whole keep from here, and all things that are tied to it. There's something about this throne and its construction. Or maybe it's something about this place.
Tell me more about Meowald.
He was a great man.
Is he gonna be like a boss?
He came here one day, young with long hair and polished armor, and he banished the dark things that had come to lurk in this place after centuries of neglect. He could see the beauty of this place, the way it had been. So he claimed it for his own when no one else would take it. We worked together to restore it. But he began to grow distant some time ago. He never told me why. He retreated deeper and deeper into the keep, never leaving, sending servants for food, hiding himself from my sight. The restoration stopped. Now, to look at the place, you'd never know the progress we'd made. In most places, it's worse than it ever was. And all I can do is watch.
Am I just following in this guy's footsteps? Maybe he's like an evil me, and he's the final boss of the entire game or something. Maybe he's that creepy guy from the very beginning at the Fabergé egg. Any idea where I can find Meyerwald?
I can feel his presence faintly somewhere deeper inside the keep. But he uses his gifts to confound me, and my senses are dulled while he does so. I only wish I could know his mind.
Farewell.
Take care in your search. Many dangers lie in wait here.
Aw, man. Oh! I guess that's what that noise was earlier.
I'm here.
Nice and quiet.
Can we, like, sleep somewhere here? Probably not. Oh, look. What's this? Some sort of treasure. Oh, it's empty. It's a treasury of emptiness. I don't know. Is something going to appear there eventually? So that seems like the way to go because she popped it open. Oh, Phantom. Okay. We'll quick save. Get into position. Whoa! Okay. Everybody unveil yourselves, I guess. Let's see if we can fight them.
What?
Alright. Magic missiles go! Okay, AoEs head out. Let's see. Do that. Oh, no, wait. Do it on this shadow. Edair, you're engaged with that thing, right? Yes. Okay. And then try and interdict him. Interdiction. Action of some sort. Gosh, man, you're getting really messed up there. Aedas, try and help him, please. Dear God. Okay, Eloth, use your AoE again.
Huh?
Wow, he went down again. Oh, he got fatigued. Okay, use this wizard shit.
Lava.
And then, let's see. Try and knock it down, I guess. It's just one left. Our dude went down real bad. Swap weapon. Oh, it's prone. Nice. Jeez, man. You're really getting messed up a lot. Maybe you need a longer range weapon. This melee stuff might not be working out for him. Are there any extra long... increased reach things. I'm not sure. Because ideally I want it one-handed, not two-handed. Because this pike is a two-handed long-range melee. Yeah, I don't know. Perhaps not. Maybe we should give him a rod instead of a mace. I'm not sure. You know what? We'll do that. We'll try this out. Oh, it's a two-hander. Okay. And there's no ranged one-handed weapon. Let's see. Two-handed. Yeah. Okay. I guess we'll just try him out with his gun. We'll see how it goes.
I'm here.
We'll mess with the formation a bit as well. We'll move him right there. Okay, so this is like a library? Looks like it. Bunch of scroll spiders have taken up residence in the empty shelves.
Keeping an eye out.
Should be in stealth mode so we can see if there's any hidden stuff. Doesn't look like it. No. Okay, and then we'll check the roof. Okay. Then, you're upstairs up. Maybe this is just a second floor, not like the roof. I don't know. Okay. The barracks. It feels as if cobwebs are the only things holding this rickety old mess together. Something has made a nest out of old straw and mattress ticking. Mattress ticking? What is that? I was expecting a giant spider of a boss. Okay. So then this room, and then we'll head into the area that I think we're meant to be.
Hello? Hello?
Oh, right, we've been in there. That's the treasury chest. The treasury chest.
Keeping quiet.
Okay. Oh!
There's my little soldier. Been out playing soldier again,
haven't you? Oh gosh, she's so loud!
Go wash up and come help me shuck these peas.
Gosh, she is so loud. She's booming. Oh my gosh. Turn down your volume, because holy shit, she's about to blast us again right up the ear hole. No? Okay. She turns from you long enough to produce a basket like that. Like her, is shimmering and semi-transparent. And no complaints, you've got to eat your vegetables if you want to grow up strong and be a real soldier one day. Just like we agreed, right? She watches you out of the corner of her eye. What are you talking about? I mean, we don't need to say anything, we'll just say nothing.
Soldiers are important people.
Oh, that one's normal.
They defend the weak and punish the wicked. You're too young to understand now, but there are lots of wicked people. People like the man who murdered your father.
She crushes another husk between finger and thumb. Remind me what happened to, my father.
Before you were born, the Glanfathans attacked settlers like us. They said we'd knocked over some of their special Adra rocks. That's why they call it the Broken Stone War. They got very angry, and so they came into our villages and killed many people. Your father was one of them.
Why would I need to say he was one of the people the Glanfathans killed? I'd just say, I see.
That's why you'll be a soldier one day. To protect. And to avenge. Why don't you go back out and play? I'll finish up here.
Man. That's kind of whack. Kind of like, totally the wrong reasons why you should be a soldier. She's a bad mamacita.
Nice right. And slow.
terrors await us within here. The silver trails of slugs gleam inside the barrels. The terrors of silver slug gleam trails. Oh, spiders. Ivory spiders. That's new, right? Oh, there's probably a big ol' spider in here, too. Like a super spider. Whoa! There's a lot! Okay. Unveil.
Hey.
And then you unveil. Okay. Oh no, wait. That's him. He needs to be on that Edith's stomach. Yeah. The bigger one.
How many?
Okay. We should probably shoot that one. It looks like it's twice two. Fight. This isn't so tough. Spiders are nothing. Okay. Everyone fight that smaller one. Finish it off real quick. You just use your knockdown. Yeah. Nice. You may as well use your knockdown. You haven't aggroed these other spiders for some reason. Oh, turned into meat. Did somebody order jibs? I think it must be Thanksgiving. Oh, what? What? Okay. Let's have a little loot. Quick save. Somehow these other spiders don't seem to mind us killing their comrades.
Right.
Or should I say comrades and legs?
Oh, God.
Oh, wow. Some sort of hellish dungeon. And a sewer. An interior sewer. I bet it gets really stinky down here. Look, it's like fuming and stuff.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea...
sea turtle. Quiet as a calm sea turtle. Eloth, use your shit. We need to be stunning. Always be stunning. Yes. Always be knocking out.
Yes.
Swap weapon again. Jeez. Heal up. Do a knockdown on that. Cool. Nailed it. Oh look, he was at 3. I wish it would like... It should be more obvious when he gets 3, because I'm not really... Maybe I'll just get used to it eventually. Or if I could automate it, I don't know. Oh, we're still in combat? No. Just residual. Ew, spider venom sac. Bulging with deadly fluids. Ugh. Okay.
I'd be glad to.
I shall be discreet.
Let's see, what have we got? Nothing? Okay, just more spiders over here to kill.
That doesn't feel right.
Oh shit, did she get poisoned or something? I have no idea. Hey, let's start throwing in AoEs.
How may I help?
Nice, I think the effect of Daze will come off too. Look, I'm just like stuck back there.
glad to.
I don't know why I'm going that way. Pathing is... leaves something to be desired at times. She is just standing looking at this giant spider, not really doing much. There we go.
Following your lead.
Come on, put in the skeletons before it wears off. Oh, nice. We actually got it off. Hopefully this doesn't bite us in the butt. I was desperate to get off the spiders. I just wanted some cool spider action. Okay, cool. It has left the party. Okay, you just get in there.
Fight on, my friends!
Okay.
Yes?
Shoot on that one. Get up in there, Durance, and heal him up. Oh, I guess I didn't really need it. I don't know why I did that. It's just missing a sliver. Oh, look. More skeletons. Must been something weird.
I cannot
they,
keep up this pace.
They called in these voice actors to
I'm here.
Chant these weird fucking lines. I don't know. I guess there's weirder things like
oh. New orders, Lieutenant. Ready your squad.
Like sex scenes in like BioWare games and all that romance. That must be pretty weird to voice. Especially with all these characters, they probably just come in like, yeah, today's the sexy day where we're gonna have you voice act all the sex with every character that you can possibly do it with. Commander. A spectral man arrayed in armor and an officer's cloak studies a single sheet of paper. You can see straight through it, and to the ducal and Adair insignias on his breastplate. He seems to read over the page several times before looking up at you. When he does, his expression is unreadable.
There's been a change of plans. Take your squad and march south all the way to the bow in the river. Bring a wagon team and a dozen barrels of pitch.
Oh shit, this is when they light up the people who, like the first guy who was like, oh, I'm on fire. His voice falters and he shakes his head. The hand holding the papers drops to his side. Tell me about the orders.
The instructions come from Admet Hadred himself. Which means they might as well have come from the Duke. We're to burn those hut dwellers out. Set fire to the Deerwood so they've nowhere to retreat. Cut them down when they come out. Or let them blaze if they won't.
A ghostly sigh forms a mist in front of his lips. So this must be all retelling of how Meyerwald came to be such a son of a bitch nowadays.
It'll make this even shorter than the Broken Stone War, all right. And we can only hope it'll discourage future conflicts.
The horrors of war.
I know this is personal for you. It is for many of us. But understand, we're doing this to end this war, not to continue the last one. Remember that we're flushing out the enemy, not burning villages for sport. Barath will have his work cut out for him tonight.
Did you just see that fucking steam pop up? I don't know if you noticed that. I tried to turn off all my friends ones, but I guess I don't know how to turn off those kind.
I'm here.
Let's check this. The cot is rough with splinters. Wow, deeper still. Jeez. You know what? We'll have a peek. Whoa! There's a big head! The old watcher. Inside the keep, I found a spirit entombed within the throne that sits in the great hall. She has opened the way down into the depths of the keep in hopes that I might find Meyerwald somewhere below.
Yes?
Hmm.
We'll take those farmers by surprise. Almost Raider. Time. Di and Heather scouted the village last night. They're rounded up the rest of the party now.
An elven man turns to face you. His cheeks, his forearms, and the cartilage of his long, pointed ears are smeared with indigo and blue paints. He grins wickedly beneath a thatch of wild hair. What party?
Don't worry. Everyone remembers the raid was your idea. The Rio had to go along with it after you got the rest of the clan riled up. No one wants it said that the Nine Claws were too cowardly to stand with the rest of the tribe when the foreigners desecrated our ruins.
The Rio? The ragged stripes of paint on his face twist as he laughs.
You may not like them, but they're still our elders, for now.
A dead gray tooth peers from between his lips.
That was clever, drawing the support of the community first. By the time you approached the Rio, they had no choice but to support us. There's no doubt you'll join their ranks one day, so long as no farmer's pitchfork fells you tonight.
He laughs.
The tribes need more leaders like you. Women who value deeds over words.
So this must be the other side of this conflict. He reaches toward your cheek, but stops midway, his splayed fingers quivering as a tremor of doubt runs through him.
You were right. We were too soft when the foreigners first came, and now they humiliate us. We'll be soft no more, and the invaders will learn to leave us alone once and for all.
Gosh.
I'm here.
We could really do with a rest.
I suppose it can't be helped.
Oh! Oh!
No.
Whoa.
Keep away from us.
Oh, it's
Leave
him!
Us.
Oh, he's tripping balls. Meyerwald. A large, liver-spotted man, barrel-chested and paunchy, cowers in the far corner of the room. His white hair, a tangled, stringy mess. He covers his face and chest with trembling hands, unable to look in your direction.
Maybe we should come back later?
Are you Meyerwald? He looks up over his hand, the muscles around his eyes twitching, and begins whispering to himself in sharp hisses, as though having an argument. Hey, maybe Aeloth knows something about this, huh? You've got like a person inside you, maybe this guy does too. All at once, he stops shaking. A sudden calmness falling over him. His head tilts forward, slightly, and he looks you dead in the eye, like a cornered animal about to pounce. His voice turns suddenly raspy.
Meyerwald isn't here.
I fucking knew it!
He isn't fooled. He has sent for no callers. Be gone, deceiving spirit.
There's another man inside this man, just like Aeloth. Except this guy has like a vile, evil snake-sounding man. Whereas Aeloth has a funny little leprechaun who likes to call people cocksmithers or something. I'm a watcher. I met a woman in Gilded Vale who thought you could help me. Please, there's something wrong with me. I need Meyerwald's help. I won't leave until I've spoken to Meyerwald. I'm no spirit. Do I look like any spirit you have ever seen? You better start making sense right now or you'll get worse than any spirit could give. I'm no spirit. Do I look like any spirit you've ever seen?
Meyerwald will speak with you, but you will maintain your distance, or you'll have me to answer to.
The old man turns his body away and has another muttered, sputtering argument facing the wall. When he turns back toward you, he has taken a confident stance, and his chest is puffed out like a soldier's. A new strength enters his voice. What? There's a lot of men inside of this guy. Yeah, we'll keep with saying that.
I'm to speak to Meyerwald. Meyerwald, whose touch is poison. Meyerwald, who knows not his effect.
The band's posture folds, and the hands he'd held strongly at his sides a moment ago resume their original tremors. His voice is feeble and tentative. I was told I'm a watcher, and then you could tell me more about it? How does this guy sound? Oh, right, he sounds like Dave Fenoy and Crispin Freeman.
And about, tablet of some worth after that. Once you two are finished, of course.
The window.
That's my best.
Window to the ether where spirits dwell. Peer and reach into it. Speak and listen through it. A watcher sees souls, reads them, knows their pasts, souls of the living, souls of the dead, an empath, and the souls see them back. Used it to help beings in both realms, did I? What the gods wanted of me, thought I.
Oh shit, he's also got Yoda inside of him.
The gods put me in the world for vengeance, and I obliged.
Oh shit, this is the soldiery guy. With a quick spasm, his shoulders straighten, and his voice becomes strong.
It was the gods' wishes that we protect those lands. My way was the only way to remove the foreigners.
He tilts his head forward, glowering at you. His voice is raspy.
Little I knew.
He shrinks down and is himself once more. He cradles his face in shaking hands. I was accosted by spirits on my way here. What do they want? You seem to have lost your mind. I mean, what good does telling him that he's lost his mind do? I was accosted by spirits on my way here. What do they want?
No. No. Forgive me. Forgive me.
Oh! I too trip balls occasionally, my friend. He covers his mouth with his hand, his breaths convulsing, his eyes red and exhausted. Oh, I see. He smoked too much weed. That's what the fire is for. He's lit, man. You seem to have lost your mind. I guess I'm just gonna say
it. Lost? No. Found more of it. Too much. Too much to bear. An awakening.
Oh. What? Oh, shit. Aloth. Aloth's eyes narrow as he looks at the old man. How could a simple awakening have driven you to this? What's an awakening? Oh, shit. It's when you have another person inside of you.
Many lifetimes we have. Souls enter womb and exit corpse. Carry with them all experiences, all knowledge, all...
So it's when you have another soul active within you, partially.
Yet we do not remember. Hidden from us. What end? What end? Only the gods know. Certain things can stir memories from lives long buried. Awaken the old memories. The old personalities. Mm-hmm. Memory, personality, identity, any might resurface. Or all.
And I seem to be having a conversation with several of them right now.
Ghosts of the mind. Meyerwald has lost control. Meyerwald's body no more.
The spirits I passed? What are they?
Spirits and not spirits. Always whispering to Meyerwald, reminding him of his mistakes. No sleep. Watchers see memories before them, form them from the essence of their own souls. Once Meyerwald awakened, he could not make them leave. Gave them more form, not less.
So he made them manifest physically? Rather than just within himself? The spirits are memories from previous lives.
Troubled memories. Angry memories, pulling Meyerwald back, reminding him his mistakes. Marauder and soldier, soldier and marauder, how could they know?
Why do these past lives still trouble you? How do you tell a spirit from a memory? I've seen apparitions like those elsewhere since I became a watcher. Yeah, that one.
Oh no, 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 no. You too. You too.
Uh-oh. Am I gonna have other people inside of me as well? All at once, in spite of his abject misery, his expression changes to one of utmost sympathy. Poor man. Poor man.
They will take you too.
What? An inevitable madness? That can't be right.
Kana folds his arms.
There's always an answer to be found. If you look hard enough.
You're saying I'll end up like you?
So fragile, the Watcher's mind. So real, his memories. Once awakened, how can he sleep?
If I'm awakened to a past life, how would that have happened?
You were reminded of it. Strong memories, lingering lives, they dwell near the surface, waiting to be remembered, waiting to take your mind for their own. Meyerwald sat at his hearth and watched his fire, watched the wood burn. Then came the memory of another fire and burning wood and screams.
His face trembles involuntarily. How do you tell a spirit from a memory?
Fragmented are memories. Stuck in time. Mindless, cruel, never far.
Why do these past lives still trouble you?
My fault. All my fault. Soldier and marauder. Soldier and marauder and Meyerwald. No forgiveness for what's past. No undoing what's done. No sleep. No sleep for the Watcher. War there was all around. War of stone. War of tree.
What about war of scissors?
He's talking about two different wars, fought back to back, long time ago. The Broken Stone War and the War of Black Trees. The usual conflicts between locals and settlers getting out of hand, both of them. Some folks are still mad about what one side did to the other.
Death we brought to the settler men. We, the Nine Claws. Claws of Nine. Worse what we did to the women. For
Jeez.
Love of the gods. The gods' love. For their love.
I met one of your memory spirits. There was talk of raiding a village. Meyerwald's voice becomes raspy, and he is somewhere else in place and time, speaking to someone unseen.
Hold her down. Head her. Give this adieu bitch an air that belongs an air glove.
Holy shit. Fucking rape her? Whoa, jeez, man. Meyerwald cringes himself again, watching something he can't bear to see. Shaking his head over and over, he wails, Jesus Christ! So he has to really... That's dark.
His soul is marked by flame, and those marks will never heal. His trial has broken him. What better than to live in weakness?
You're such a fucking asshole, Durrance. Jesus Christ. keep talking. I'm enjoying this. Ugh. You are a monster. You deserve this, even for a past life. Terrible things happen in war. Living with what you've done is its own penance. That's enough. I don't want to know anymore. Take your time. It's over now. It was long ago. Continue when you're ready. Go on. Yeah, continue when you're ready. I mean, there's nothing you can do about it. Like, what good is going to come from being an asshole here? Take your time. It's over now. It was long ago. Continue.
The boy. The boy. The baby boy. The boy. Conceived in the raid. Conceived by force. Vessel for marauder. Slain in the raid. Marauder and the boy. Marauder and soldier.
Maybe the boy is that cloaked figure from earlier. A baby conceived by the raider? What do you mean it was a vessel for him?
For the soul. A marauder's soul. Same soul. One soul. Boy's soul. Marauder's soul. Raised in lies and vengeance. Raised to soldier. Raised for the fire. Born for the fire.
Oh, that's the mother figure. Oh, then that was his mother I met in the keep. She told him his father was killed by the raiders.
You'll get no pity from me. The crimes of the Nine Claws clan in the last war are still unavenged. But the gods are just. They have led me here. In my father's name, every one of you will burn. Light it.
What? So he came back in his next life to burn his own clan? No wonder he's such a mess now. That'll stain you right down to your soul. Meyerwald's shoulders slump. He rocks back and forth, agitated. He mutters to himself, oblivious to your presence.
Soldier and marauder, lies and vengeance, and dead villages. All dead. All dead. What for? What for?
I don't know. Your soul is given to wickedness. The only question is why the gods don't tear it apart. I see no reason, just bad luck. Whatever the reason, I don't think we're meant to know. You speak in riddles. I don't have the patience to try and understand. Soldier and marauder, lives and vengeance, dead villages. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know why. Why they would... Yeah, I just don't know. I don't know.
How little we know.
Yeah. There must be some way to make these memories go away.
No. Always there. Always remembered. Can't forget. Can't unsee.
I didn't just remember. Someone caused this. They wore masks and spoke of books and keys and a queen. There was a man there. He seemed familiar to me.
Keys of lead. Books of burden. Queens that were. Known to me are they. The leaden key.
The leaden key. It seems we share an enemy, Lyle. Assassins and watcher wakers both. They certainly keep busy.
What can you tell me about this leaden key?
Secrets. Secrets and deceptions and schemes. Who knows their answers? Not they. Not they. Crossed them before. Hatred of watchers. Hatred and fear. Much we see. Threat to secrets.
Who is this queen they pray to?
Woodica.
Goddess. Oh, shit!
Crown shattered and body burned. Binder of oaths and grudge holder. Bearer of justice. But whose?
Freaking Durance was talking about her earlier. What did he say? Something reminded him of Woodica. If the Leyden Key caused my awakening, could they undo it?
Many secrets do they keep. Unawaken? Mayhap. Who else if not they?
I mean, fair enough. It's pretty cool to have these powers, but I don't want to... I want to get rid of them eventually, right? Because eventually I'll go freaking nuts like this guy. Do you know where I might find the Leyden Key?
City of Defiance. Never far from the queen.
I need to go so I can search for this man from the Leyden Key.
Sleep well. Sleep well.
You just want to stay down here?
Hold.
Oh.
I know your will die.
Oh!
Your actions were seen. You would sooner betray us to the Adia land thieves than take orders from me.
Take it easy. I'm not going to betray anyone. Well, for now, as far as I know.
Your betrayal is for nothing. Your warnings are lost on these foreigners, and their blood will be Galloway's tribute this night. I have asked the elders for the honor of claiming your head as my first trophy, and they have granted it. beg for the Seeker God to grant you a quick death.
Oh, shit! Boss fight? Am I gonna fight him? Oh! Oh, no! We're not ready at all. Oh, shit. That's not good. That's not good at all. What are these? Flame Blight? Okay. Shit. This is gonna be tough. Okay. Fight these. Okay. Swap to your ranged weapon. Shoot him. Because he has piercing damage, so he can't hurt anything else. Cast this? No, don't start casting yet. Me, I will shoot him.
Wait.
Get up in there. Okay, swap weapon. Shoot him again. Can we knock down this thing, please? Okay. Throw down that. Interdiction, if you can. Okay, please get in there. Okay. Actually, I take it back. Use that instead. Okay. Another knockdown. Okay. Swap weapon again. Maybe we should eat this pie. Keep shooting, Marowalf. Who's this thing attacking? Okay, I can get out of here. Okay.
Yes.
There we go. Okay, sweet. Get that in there. Skeletons. Jeez. Everyone self-heal if you can. Okay. Durance, get on that thing. You, Aloth, get on that thing as well. And then the two of us. Keep shooting, Meerwald. Okay, Edir. Jesus, man. Who is this thing fighting? Oh no. Can he just run? Maybe? That ain't good.
We had some good.
Yeah, just get out of there, Edir. You're way too low. Jesus, you can't escape, can you?
Don't even slow it down!
Alright then.
More skeletons, please! Please, more skeletons.
Following your lead. Stand!
Okay, Edir, switch ranged. Start shooting him.
I need some help here.
Jesus. This thing is taking like no damage.
This isn't working.
You've done something.
More skeletons. Gosh. Oh, jeez. Do you have a potion you can just ale? Okay, everyone. Time for the big showdown. Gosh. Oh gosh. We did it! Oh my god, we freaking did it! Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
I cannot keep up this pace.
Yeah, you and me both, buddy. Holy shit! That was so close! Oh, down to the wire! Okay. There is a change in the air of the keep. What was thick and suffocating feels to you somehow more breathable, as though yielding to a conquering invader. Meriwald's body lies inert. You can feel his soul, but the soul lives on. Soul lingering there, uncertain. There is something unique about this soul in this place. A bond formed in decades of inhabitants and lordship that feels somehow palpable to you. Even in death, the keep knows its former master. And the former master remembers his keep.
Whoa! Granted speaker to the restless.
Oh shit. In your mind's eye, the bond seems to you as frayed rope, ghostly and alive. Its frayed ends writhing like tide pool anemones, and you find that if you concentrate on it, you have the ability to manipulate its strands. Sever the rope, allowing Meriwald to pass from the world. Repair the rope, binding Meriwald's soul here as an eternal warden. Draw upon the energy of the rope itself, siphoning knowledge from the connection. In your mind's eye, the bond appeared. Okay. So, we should probably sever the rope, that way he doesn't get stuck here. Right? Yeah, we'll sever the rope. I think that seems like the right thing to do. Because if he's here as an eternal warden, he's just kind of... he's going to be upset. Like, that, what a bummer thing. We'll sever the rope. Strand by strand, the connections fly apart like the overstressed strings of some ethereal instrument. With the tearing of the final string, the rope becomes liquid and dissolves from your awareness. Meriwald's soul hovers near you, a vortex of strife and discord. But there is something else there beneath it, something like relief. His soul passes through one of the walls and is gone. Whoa! Holy crap. Speak with the steward in Cade Nua. Get all this. Whoa, more stuff. Oh right, because we were supposed to bring Edir. To meet that guy. Edir will have to decide how to proceed from here. Okay, first let's get our loot on. Oh look, they want to talk as well. That's nice, I never noticed that before. Let's loot. Oh, his grimoire. Primal Wind. Okay, we'll just put all that in the stash. Okay. Wow, that went on pretty long, but I didn't expect all this in this tiny little room in the basement. Like, boss fight and everything. But somehow we pulled it out in the end, even through all of our debilitations and lack of spells and all that. Okay. I guess when we come back, we'll talk to everybody. We'll talk to that chair upstairs. We'll see what's going on. Maybe we'll be able to claim this throne and we'll figure out more stuff about this queen. Peace!